Hey everyone, my name's Chris, and I'm doing a review of the Toshiba L355D S907 laptop. It's a satellite series, so satellite L355D S907 laptop. And this just came out April 2nd, so it's brand new. Not brand spanking new, like it's not April 3rd when I'm posting this, it's April 22nd. But I've had it for about a week, and I love it. It's great. It's got a DVD-R, DVD-RW, dual-layer DVD burner. Basically, it does everything that you want out of an optical drive, short of, this kind of makes me upset if you didn't see by that face, Blu-ray and HD DVD, so it's not prepped for HD future, but, you know, a year ago, this would have been really big. It does everything that I needed to do. It burns DVDs, burns dual-layer DVDs, rewrites DVDs, burns CDs, reads CDs, reads DVDs, etc. Processor is the AMD Turion 64 x2 Mobile Technologies dual-core processor, with 2.0 gigahertz of processing power on each core, which is nice. I've got 2 gigs of RAM, DDR2 RAM. I don't know what the difference is of regular RAM and DDR2. I think it's 667 megahertz of front-side bus. It's got a 200 gigabyte hard drive, Wi-Fi with 802.11b and g, not the N. You know, wireless is wireless, not true, but for me, wireless is wireless. I use an Ethernet cable. I know it's a notebook, but this is it's kind of acting like a desktop replacement for this Dell Dimension piece of shit I got in 2004. They had 512 megs of RAM, and I tore it to pieces. This is not what it looked like when it was new. There's no drives. The optical drive broke after the one-year warranty, like a month after the one-year warranty was up. So, and every time I tried to buy a new one, it wouldn't work. It would say, "All right, we see that you have a drive, but you don't have any drivers for it." So I thought, okay, I'll download the drivers. Click. Well, there's no drive that these drivers are supporting. You don't have a drive in the computer. You need to get a drive. I'm like, well, it's right there. It's like, well, where's the drivers? I'm like, drivers are here. Where's the drive? And apparently, my uncle says that Dell does this so that you have to buy Dell dedicated drivers. I just bought, you know, I actually have it right here, this HP DVD RW drive. To say that it was supposed to go in here, or I don't know. Yeah, and I put it in, hooked it all up. You know, it was saying, this doesn't work. You have to buy a Dell one, pretty much. My uncle says, you buy a Dell one, and it'll recognize it right away. Kind of a scam for money, you know. They don't want you to buy other people's products. It's supposed to be plug and play. And it met the system requirements, met the operating system requirements. Didn't work. Really pissed me off. So yeah, I had this thing with 512 megs of RAM. No, 256. I thought it was 512 for a while. Then I finally checked the specs, and I was like, oh, well, this sucks even more than I thought it did. I tried to use it for Photoshop, kind of funny. I'm a photographer. That's why I mainly use my computer for is graphic design and the internet and email and iTunes. I have that always running for music. It's not running now because I'm making a video. And basically, going from this to what I'm using now, huge difference. 2 gigs of RAM is amazing. Incredibly fast. I mean, I load Photoshop in about maybe 15 seconds, 15 to 20 seconds after all the license. That's with everything gone, the licensing equipment and all that goes through, registers, and I'm up ready with Photoshop. I can open documents, toolbars up, everything. 20 seconds. 8 seconds for iTunes. I heard that's pretty good. I can't really compare it to this thing because I didn't really play music on it because it would bog down everything else, and I couldn't afford to use up those 256 megs of RAM. 256, if I said 512. I know I corrected myself already, but if I said 512 any time since, go ahead and replace that with 256. I needed every bit of it that I could get out of it. So, iTunes, 8 seconds, here that's fast. My girlfriend has a 1 gigabyte RAM HP computer, and that thing boots it in about 25, 30 seconds, and that's just half as much memory. It's probably because this computer's newer, It's running Vista, which is making the upload, the boot times a little slow. A lot of people give Vista, a lot of crap. It's not that bad. I have a little bit of Mac envy because I was gonna get a Mac, so I downloaded a dock and a status bar at the top, and the OS X background, the OS X cursor set, and the icons. It looks like I'm running a Mac. Only thing short of that I don't have is the skin, which is like a $20 program that'll just make, it'll flip the, is this on the right side for you? Yeah, it'll flip the X, close, maximize, minimize things to the other side, and then add that metal shiny thing, and then the drop shadow. Vista already has a drop shadow, but, it'll basically turn it into a full Mac visually. It'll still have all the problems of Vista, or XP, or any Windows machine, but it'll look like a Mac. And it'll still have the compatibility pluses of the Windows machine. That's one thing I do have to say. It's good for Windows. Every program pretty much is written for it, except for a few Mac goodies and maybe a few Linux goodies. I'm not a Linux person. No offense if you are. If you like Linux, if you like Mac, if you like OS X or Windows, Vista, XP, Windows 2000, 95, I don't care. I'm not one of those fanboys. I won't fight for anything. But, Vista's not that bad. I think it's robbing a little bit of my RAM resources, but going from 256 to 2 gigs is just, it doesn't matter how much it's robbing it. For me, it's fast as can be. I don't care how much the eye candy's robbing because I'm just not used to this speed as it is. Maybe I'll start getting pickier later. Mainly use this computer for graphic design, Photoshop, Adobe Flash, and music and stuff. I think I already said that. Anyway, great computer. Also has a dedicated graphics card. It's not, insanely powerful. It's got 128 megs of dedicated video RAM, 856 megs of shared. That's better than nothing. I went from integrated graphics. I keep comparing to this thing that ruined my life, almost. Not ruined, but it's caused several projects to not work, and it had viruses out the wazoo. It had this one virus that would just constantly minimize whatever window I was using at the time, and I can't touch type, so I'd always be looking out at the keyboard, and it would just minimize the window, and I'd be typing, I'd type a long paragraph, I'd look up, and I'd re-maximize the window, and I'd type the first two letters, and it would do that about every 45 seconds, it would just minimize the window. Then occasionally it would go on for 3 or 4 minutes without minimizing the window, just getting me comfortable enough with it to let me screw up, when I was trying to type up stuff. It's just, I hated it. It was horrible. This doesn't have any viruses. I've got some antivirus stuff. Norton, people say it's crap. I don't have anything, but, I'm being good. I'm not downloading any music or anything. And if I do, I test it on this machine, but I haven't downloaded anything since I've gotten this. It's, because my CD-ROM drive works. I need to tell you guys about that. I already did tell you guys about that. Sorry. I made 2 videos today because I realized that this horrible camera had a worse setting that I was accidentally using, thinking it was the best setting. This isn't too good anyway, but it's better than, trust me, it's better than what it was, or otherwise my face would be like one pixel for each eye, and it was horrible. Barely even suited to make an icon on that setting. I think it was 120 pixels by 180 or something. It was bad. This is much better. Perfect square though. The other one was it was a weird shape. I don't know why they. Off topic. Bad camera on the Toshiba. If you're gonna get that. I'm running out of time. I'm pretty sure you guys are happy. I'm expecting a slew of negative comments. I've never even had a camera before, a video camera. I've got, of course, a cinematographer. I've got this. It's not with me. I've got a very nice still camera, but this is pretty cool. I hope this helps someone who's looking to buy this laptop. Toshiba retails it for $799. I think it's a great deal. 17-inch screen is amazing. It's not as good as the 19-inch I have. I'm running dual screens, VGA plug and play. That's good. And but it's a good machine. Office Depot, if you can find the deal I had, you can get it for $599. So good luck with that. I'm running out of time, so just have a good day. And if you guys liked it, tell me, and I'll make more videos. All right, bye.